bom.
Come here.
Stop.
Stop being so scared. He's gonna bite you. I'm not even gonna bite you hard.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Bad 19. I'm Brandon Gunn, and of course, guys, here at the VH Club. So that's your fans, and that's the best of that. One of 45 stars. We're playing with you to a fast pace, live for the show. And if you see the other shows, we're off in this way.
Hello, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and partner, our weeks away, we're back to playing football.
And this is way better than Watergate, isn't it? Now we get to have some fun. Watch the veterans, they'll play a little bit, we know that. But the big thing is new crop of rookies and young guys, they get their chance to take the field and earn their spot.
Here's the kicker, Zane Gonzalez, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from MetLife Stadium. Here's Khalif Raymond to return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So here are the Giants fans starting to get the game. And that running back by the Giants center will of course be Eli Manning in his 15th season now, the former number one pick in 2004.
When you look at the numbers that Eli Manning posted in 2017, there's plenty of cause for concern. Most yards per completion of his career, fewest yards passes since 2008. His numbers continue to drop in terms of touchdowns and rising in terms of interceptions. But he's one of the fiercest competitors in the league, even if you can't tell it by his game. Secondary. When I watch them, They remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. Ready to come out now. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but team defensively, they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There was none there for him.
Now it's the backup low. After the sack, they'll come up now, third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And instead, they want to throw it on play action. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roll free and brings up fourth down. Thank you.
Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, you take a look at this Giants ball club.
And I don't think from what we saw down on the field before the game is any doubt they're ready to roll.
They pass the eye test, don't they? This team looks fired up and ready to play.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Jaguars, an early season. Down to two, we get a signal and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And we are back here. I'm waiting guard alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes the timeout. And now we're set to get going. Midfield, here's Manning. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Pressure, that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they're able to get in there and influence the throw. Remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck rule that they can fall back on anymore.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. On third and long, it's Manning. He'll buy some time right. And Ingram holds it in. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. And they convert on third with a gain of 22.
Look at the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurate when he throws a nice pass for a first down.
Working from the gun, Manning.
move to the regular season, that's a great way to get started. First drive of the season, what a nice completion.
So another third down conversion, and now they've got a first and goal. And Barkley will try to punch it in. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop it right around the one.
To me, that's a terrific run on first and goal with the three. They got 2 yards. I'd line right back up and give it to them again.
They'll give it to him up the middle. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2 yard line. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal. Here's Barkley.
Methodical and almost like a boxing match where you hit them with body blows. They can withstand them here. Look, they give up the touchdown, but you don't feel like a knockout is there. But they keep doing that in the fourth quarter. That's when the knockout occurs.
It becomes tough for that defense if they're on the field that long. We'll see if they can continue that in future drives. Rosas scored with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. So that was a long 11-play drive, and it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Rosas now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. There's somebody to return that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. So here's the first drive now for the Jags. They'll be led out by their quarterback from Central Florida. It's Blake Bortles.
And you can see why he was the number 3 pick when he came out of the NFL draft. 6'5", sturdy guy, strong arm, led his UCF team to a big bowl victory over Baylor, and runs the ball way better than he's ever given credit for.
A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. Officially no gain on the play. Second down. Second down, here's Fournette. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of 2, now third down.
Came down the power set, that one served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you want to do that, you got to win on front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
Throwing his Bortles on third down. This is Yeldon on the jump ball. And a nice little quick spender before he's dropped. And a pretty good game. It's a gain of 7. And it'll be fourth down.
There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood where the third down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that, bringing up fourth down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely 3-and-out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure they didn't give up much run after catch.
The Giants making their way out, and at this point, you would have to think that all mentions of last year are maybe erased from team history. At least that's what they want. It clearly, Charles, correct me if I'm wrong, the talent on this team, too good for another 3-13 finish, right?
And I think that was reflected in their draft in 2018. Because if it was an all-out rebuild, they would have drafted a quarterback in number 2. Instead, they drafted Saquon Barkley. So that signals to me they want to get back to running the football and trying to punish people on offense and take the pressure off of Eli Manning. And on the defensive side of the ball, they obviously have to get better. But believe it or not, you know who can really help them there? Their head coach, Pat Shermer. Comes from a defensive family, understands how valuable it is, and loves the toughness and the identity that a good defense can provide.
Now we've got a giant player here, slow to get up after that last play. Boy, not what you want to see in quarter 1 of the new year. We'll be back. The Giants on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. They'll try and run with their fullback. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. Now Riley Dixon on. He did his collegiate kicking upstate at Syracuse. Back deep with Rashad Green. And now a low liner. I think he mishit him. And now a fair catch called for and taken just outside the 40-yard line. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And the Jaguars go on offense, 1st down and 10. Meanwhile, checking in on what's going on in Baltimore. The Jags heading out on offense. Well, last year, we said, Charles, that one of these years that had to come together for the Jaguars. They won that punt. It certainly did. They won double-digit games for the first time in 10 seasons. And they picked up 2 more wins in the playoffs before falling in that tough one in New England.
And they decided that on offense, they were going to be a team that knocked you off the ball and ran it. That's why they drafted Leonard Fournette out of LSU. He gave them some toughness and an identity. Quarterback Blake Bortles, often criticized, but elevated his play in the playoffs, both with his legs and his arm. For the defense, that's where the big transition happened. Yannick Ngakoue coming off the edge. Calais Campbell, maybe the best player on the defensive line in the league last season. But Jalen Ramsey out of corner, he gives them their swagger, he gives them their look, and he gives them great play on the edge.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Alongside the former defensive back Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. It's Jaguar football as we begin quarter number 2. They've got it 2nd and 6 to start things out. They'll run it again with Fournette. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. They lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
Somebody's protocols. I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to say I'm in this booth, right? They make all the calls, and they think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise, this defense is going to gang up on the run and shut them down.
From the gun on 3rd down, Bortles. And that is incomplete.
Let's go ahead and try and get to the body and the mind of the linebacker. Yeah, I know they're bigger and stronger than I ever was, but in this situation, they understood what was going on as much as the offensive guys. Because the offensive guys always talk, find the first down sticks and make the play. On defense, what do you want to do? Guard the first down line and make sure they don't get there and tackle them in front. They were able to drop in their zone coverage, figure out where the first down line was, and end up making the play, swatting it away so they couldn't get the completion.
And here comes the Giants offense back out onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get it.
Line. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. And now they come up and spike it to stop the clock. Giants on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This is third and 14. On play action. Now Manning. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
How about this offense already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive? They certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more out to take a shot like that downfield.
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try pressure advantage.
Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. That's pulled in at the 32. A good return there, 17 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. Comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot, great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. A well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. Now on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Shotgun now for Bortles. He goes underneath for Yeldon. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
And I know you can't really see it, but that play spells frustration with a capital F for the guys on defense. They covered everyone else. End up going to the running back out of the backfield. And he picks up a back break from first down.
Fournette, a first down carry. And a solid run down inside the 30. They'll get a nice chunk down the first down run, and it's second and four. Looking back to Leonard Fournette's rookie campaign, over 1,000 yards rushing. And coming into the league, some people saw this kid as the next Adrian Peterson. What can we expect from him going forward?
I like the comparison because of the size, the strength, the speed. And I think he catches the ball better than Adrian Peterson. So I think they can up his utilization in the passing game. But what really impressed me was down the stretch in the divisional playoff game against Pittsburgh. Hurt his ankle, left the game for a while, and came back to help power his team to a big victory. Remember, he had some dings at LSU that kept him out for a few games. I thought that was a great deal for Leonard Fournette.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for Jumbo.
Infraction defense.
So they got him coming up from his linebacker spot.
And sometimes the position designation really doesn't matter. If you creep up to the line of scrimmage, you just have to look for the football. Make sure it moves before you do.
After the penalty is Fournette, and he is going to lose yardage here. Two plays with only negative yardage to show, and now it's third and six. the gun. It's Bortles. Yeah, incomplete. The contact made the ball roll free and brings up fourth down. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there and gets the good defensive position, able to affect the play.
Lambeau will put this one through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays, yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those 9-play drives pay dividends later, but another 9-play drive that culminates in a touchdown and they wear down a defense.
Inside the 45-yard line.
But just about every special teams meeting, there's a discussion with the punter about his importance. Why? He can flip the field for your team defensively, move it deep into their own territory, or if you're backed up on offense and you hit a big punt and change field position and help his defense. In this case, though, field position got flipped by the return team. You can do it so many different ways on special teams.
Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 2. Those Giant fans, you know that they love seeing Saquon Barkley wearing their jersey, but it's interesting, he actually grew up a Jets fan.
Yeah, I wonder what his dad was thinking. Only the guy was thinking on draft night. Had to be so happy for his son. But they grew up watching Jets games, just sit together, watch it. In fact, Dad has a Jets tattoo. Okay, so that tells you about how much he loves that team. You think Saquon's going to fix that and make it a Giants tattoo?
Yeah, he wants to make that a Giants tattoo. That family, though, they fully converted. They're supporting the G-Men. The Giants on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. To throw it is Manning. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Jacksonville's pass defense holds serve. Fourth down. We're back to East Rutherford. But first, this timeout. A reminder coming up at the half. We hook up with a new guy, Jonathan Coachman from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis, and more importantly this year, scores and stats from around the league. So he must press that skip button. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. On 1st and 10, he couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. On 2nd down, here's Barkley. Push his way forward here for a good bit of game. Given 4 on the ground there, they're now left with 3rd and 6.
One thing to keep in mind, Patner, especially in the second half, if you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, because some of these shorter games turn into bigger runs later.
That'll get him the 1st down as they get 9 yards out of that quick slant.
I feel like Eli Manning has just gone from downfield bomber to a guy who can complete everything.
Can hit him underneath now.
Yeah, we just saw that there with that pass completion. The maturity of a veteran taken with the defensive given.
A 1st down carry for Barkley. So a nice job to break the 1 tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. They gave him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
He did have the touchdown run earlier, but not a heck of a lot more than that throughout this game.
No, not at all. In fact, I would say that the